Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to create this really nice grungy grainy effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. All right, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command N, and I will keep the setting the same, 2000 by 2300 in the resolution, and I will press OK. All right, now we'll go and add a solid color. Yeah, maybe I will keep it like this, delete this one, and then I will go to my folder and open the image I want to use. So I will make it bigger. Yeah, around this, I think it looks okay. All right, now I want to make a selection of the model, but I want to do it using the polygonal lasso tool because I want to have that effect that it looks like it's a cutout, but in a subtle way. So we'll start from here. All right, now I want to exclude this space that we have between the hand and the head. So I'm just gonna press Alt or Option, and this will actually subtract it from the selection, just like this. All right, once we are happy with that, I will one click on the layer mask. And that's what we have now. I think it looks okay. Now we'll right click, convert to smart object, and then we're gonna start adding our filter. But before we're gonna do that, make sure that you have in the foreground and the background color set to the default. This is very important because there are some filters that actually linked with the colors that you have in here or react to the color that you have in here. As you can see, I have it set to purple to white, so I'm just going to press D on my keyboard and this will turn into the default. All right, next I will go to filter and choose filter galleries while I'm having this selected. All right, so we're going to apply two filters from here. The first one is the texture, which is the grain, and you know, experiment with this, but for this image I'm going to put intensity 100 and the contrast maybe 75 or 80. Yeah, like that. I have the grain type set to the regular, and then I will one click on this plus icon to add a new filter. And the second one, it will be in the sketch tone edges, and for this one I will take down the image balance to 20 and the smoothness 15 and the contrast maybe 18, and I think it looks okay, and I hope it's okay. All right, as you can see, our effect is almost done. Now I will go and add blending options while I'm having the main layer selected, of course, and then I will go and select stroke because I want to have this white stroke coming out from the image. I'm just gonna put 5 in the size, the position is outside, 100% opacity, and white in the color, and I'm gonna press OK. All right, now I want to add a little bit of color in the glasses and also in the lips, and to do that I'm gonna create a new layer and call this colors, and then I will switch to my brushes, and I have actually the mode of the brush set to the dissolve for me to follow actually this. As you can see, when it's dissolve, you will see that it's dissolving the color. So I will go and select maybe purple color for the glasses, and maybe I will put the hardness around 70 because I don't want actually to keep painting just like that. All right, now we'll go and select another color for the lips, maybe an orangey color. All right, and I will start painting in the lips in here. All right, I think it looks all right. Now while I'm having the color layer selected, I will go and choose blending options again. And this time I will go to the blend if section where it said underline layer in the black slider. I'm gonna press Alt or Option and this will split it. Then we'll take it to 0 to 120 and I will press OK. And as you can see, this will make it blend perfectly. And now the only thing that I want to add is a texture. So I will go and open the texture I want to use. I will drag it in here. and rotate it. Make it bigger to fit, just like this. All right. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of it to screen. And there we go. That will be our effect. As you can see, this was very easy and simple to do. Let me actually make it bigger to fit, just like this. And again, you can actually change the background color to maybe something darker, or even a different color if you want. As you can see, it looks really cool like this. And yeah, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this video and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.